July 23rd, 2020 has come and gone. Microsoft's long-awaited Series X Games Conference is in the books. What you thought of it might depend on how you see the future of gaming. If you're invested in the Xbox ecosystem and happen to have the Game Pass subscription service, then what you saw likely got you excited, as quite a few of the titles shown will be available on Game Pass day one. After watching the show, I can't deny that Microsoft has a truly great offering with the Game Pass subscription model, and it seems likely that it'll continue to improve as the service matures. Unfortunately, even so, many of the games displayed at the conference are assumed to be 1 to 3 years from final release. Microsoft, knowingly, has been struggling for the last 5 years on how to go about securing and developing strong first-party titles that gamers actually want to play. Seeing the success that Sony has had over the last generation and the strong demand for single-player story-driven based games has put Microsoft in a hole that I'm not sure they can dig themselves out of. The sad reality is that Microsoft ditched the practice of ensuring that they have software to sell hardware. The Xbox One has had few and far between titles that are exclusive to the console outside of Halo, Forza, Gears, and the well-received Sunset Overdrive. A massive contrast from the days of the Xbox 360 and especially the original Xbox. Now, given the strong contrast from the prior generations of the Xbox, we finally got a little bit of hope, and that hope was Phil Spencer. Phil Spencer realized what was happening and what gamers actually wanted on their platform. He made some rather quick moves and received approval from Microsoft to purchase development teams for their Xbox Game Studio first-party fleet of software. This was a bold and exciting time to be an Xbox gamer, finally. Phil Spencer was even visiting developers in Japan. I mean, how crazy is that? The market share is almost non-existent for Xbox in Japan. The good news here is, while it took Microsoft quite a few years to understand what was actually happening, for once Xbox gamers felt their voices heard. They stood by Microsoft's side patiently as conference after conference they demoed trailers and talked about games of the future. It wasn't a great time to be an Xbox gamer, but the moves they were making as a whole gave us a glimmer of hope. Fast forward a couple of years, and that takes us to last week's Xbox Series X gaming event. This showcase was an event that was supposed to knock the ball out of the park. This was supposed to be the event that would be the answer to Sony's stellar PS5 conference just a month prior. Unfortunately, we are living another year of being told, hey, games are on their way, check out these cool trailers, with very little substance or intrigue to capture new fans to the platform. It's not to say that what we saw was all underwhelming, but it's hard to get excited for trailers that did a little more than make you ask more questions about the games than they answered. For example, Rare's Everwild. The trailer was pretty neat, but it didn't give us any insight as to what gameplay would be like. You kind of found yourself asking questions, why do we want to play this game? Why should we be excited? And similarly enough, I felt the same questions being asked over and over again by myself as I watched the games conference. Shockingly, we didn't even see actual Forza 8 gameplay. We were shown an in-engine trailer, but that was it. On top of this, Forza won't be a launch game for the Series X, as it's reported to be at least a year out from release. The question has to be asked then, how has Microsoft allowed for such bad timing of even their own well-established first-party titles to miss the launch of the most powerful gaming console ever created? It just really racks my brain. The only game of substance we were shown was that of Halo Infinite, and an 8-minute gameplay segment at that. If you have an internet connection and you follow gaming, then I'm sure you know just how polarizing that gameplay demo actually was. I have to admit, I agree with both sides. What we saw was both exciting and extremely underwhelming. Back to the main show, we saw some great-looking trailers for games like Obsidian's Avowed, Playground Games' Fable, and the new title called Gunk. But again, these were only trailers for games that are years away. There's not much to really get excited about. For the third year in a row, Microsoft has struggled to produce any worthwhile content for their home console, and at a time when it may matter most, they won't have much in the form of first-party content at the launch of the Series X. Whether Microsoft can weather the storm or have a somehow spectacular August conference, the survival of the brand is to be seen. Microsoft, while making a large amount of money from their subscription services, likely will be in a tough place should the Xbox Series X not take off, much akin to the Xbox One in 2013. In summary, I feel that Xbox gamers are just a little bit let down by Microsoft. There was a lot riding on the July 23rd conference, and especially all the industry insiders that were touting it as being one of the best conferences in the brand's history kind of left me scratching my head. I'm not sure what the future holds for Microsoft, but personally, I'm not a fan of them shifting to, say, software-only releases, much like Sega. I know that they're moving to the cloud with Game Pass and with xCloud. I think Microsoft, however, does a great job on the hardware side of things, and I would hate to see that innovation disappear from the market. A lot is to be seen, and as a big Xbox fan, I'm still hopeful. I'm excited for the future. I just wish there was more of a reason to buy an Xbox. Microsoft hasn't provided enough value and content for someone to make the leap. Let's really hope there's more coming up in August. And I'd love to hear below what you all thought of the game showing. What was your favorite game? What was your least favorite game? And where do you see the Xbox brand in the next 5 years? Thanks for tuning in.